Good morning, class 9. The topic for today is cell division. How do cells multiply? You know, when an animal or plant grows, it gets larger. To enable the organism to increase in size, the cells divide to form more cells. One thing you should keep in mind that the new cells arise from pre-existing cells. So this process by which new cells are formed by division of pre-existing cells is called cell division. You know, children, that life starts from a single cell, zygote. Zygote is formed after fusion of male and female gamete during fertilization. This zygote is the first cell from which the whole organism is formed. How the whole organism is formed from this single cell? Because one cell divides into 2, 2 into 4, and so on and so forth. Now the question arises, how do cells divide? Now the cell which has to divide is called the parent cell. It becomes large. Then first the nucleus of the cell splits into two, and then the cell divides into two separate cells across the middle. The two new cells which are formed after this division are called daughter cells. These grow to their full size and then divide again, so this process continues. Besides growth, cell division is also necessary for replacement of dead cells. And millions of cells die and are replaced every second in our body. Now, this kind of cell division, which takes place in all the general cells of our body, it's called mitosis. So the picture which is given here, you can see it is showing the mitosis. One parent cell gives rise to two daughter cells. Now, one more thing which is to be noticed here is that the number of chromosomes. You know what are chromosomes? Chromosomes are present inside the nucleus in the form of chromatin material, and these chromosomes carry heredity information on them in the form of genes. During cell division, these chromosomes, they condense, this chromatin material condenses into chromosomes. Now, every species has got a fixed number of chromosomes. For example, human beings have got 46 chromosomes, and these chromosomes exist in pairs. That means they exist in 23 pairs. So, in this process of mitosis, the number of chromosomes remains same as in the parent cell. Now, besides mitosis, there is one more kind of division which takes place in our reproductive organs during the formation of gametes. You know, gametes are special cells. They are sex cells. Male gamete is called the sperm and the female gamete is called egg or ovum. When these gametes are formed inside the testes or ovaries, a special type of cell division takes place, which is named meiosis. Now, in this process, one cell undergoes two consecutive divisions, resulting in four daughter cells or gametes. Now, the gametes will have half the number of chromosomes as compared to the parent cell. That means instead of 46 chromosomes, now each gamete will have only 23 chromosomes. Now, the picture which is shown here, the next slide, it is showing the process of meiosis, that how one cell, it is undergoing first meiosis 1 and then meiosis 2, and it is forming four daughter cells. And you can see that the number of chromosomes, it is, look at the parent cell and now look at the daughter cells which are formed. It is just half as compared to the parent cell. Now the question arises, why do the gametes need to have half the number of chromosomes in them? Now this is because during reproduction, when male and female gametes unite during the process of fertilization to form zygote, the resulting zygote will have complete number of chromosomes. That means 23 come from the male gamete and 23 from the female gamete. Therefore, zygote and subsequently the new offspring will have 46 chromosomes. Now, based on whatever we have studied till now, let us now try to differentiate between mitosis and meiosis. Now, mitosis takes place in all the body cells. Meiosis takes place only in the reproductive organs during the formation of gametes. In mitosis, one cell divides to form two daughter cells. In meiosis, one cell produces four daughter cells by undergoing two successive divisions. The number of chromosomes remains same as in the parent cell in mitosis, but in meiosis, the number of chromosomes become half. Then, mitosis is important for growth and repair of tissues, and meiosis is important for the formation of gametes in sexually reproducing organisms. Thank you, children.